The first time you view it, that's one field of view. Then when you move the slide, you get a new field of view. When I'm in class, I'm excited about science, and they feed off my excitement. The class is set up with a new textbook where they analyze data, and then we learn scientific concepts through that analysis as a discussion. There's more thinking, there's more processing. They need to know science. That's how we know things. We know our car isn't going to explode because science tells us so. We know that we're going to get sunburned because science says it's so. We have data to support everything. So I tell them, all of my students, if the data doesn't support it, then don't believe it. The labs are set up to be a student-designed lab. This is an AP, where I give them a problem and they have to investigate a particular property where they design the lab. In the past few years, I've just given them equipment, put the problem on the board and say, there you go, figure it out. And first time they hear that from a teacher, they are petrified. They look at me like, what? Where's our directions? Like, you got this. And I just stand back and they do it. It's amazing. You know, I want to be the teacher that they remember. And who remembers the teachers that were easy? Right? Everybody remembers the teachers that worked their tails off and were tough and never gave them answers. You know, I tell them, I'll ask a question, but I won't answer it. That's for you to do. And I hear from kids from college. You know, I really like that.